Listen, today, a lot of Christians are compromising their values. We are throwing away our Christianity. We don't have values again. We can't stand for God again in this generation. We have compromised our values today. Christians, homosexuality. We are talking about homosexuality, and Christians cannot even speak against it. Because the world is telling us inclusivity. We have to be inclusive. You know, we have to accommodate everybody. But meanwhile, we know that it is wrong. Because for me, he said, our donors will not support us. And meanwhile, we claim that Ghana is a Christian country. But yeah, you're sure, we don't look like a Christian country at all. Because there's corruption in this country, and it is always Christians that we claim that in the church. We can't stand for Christ. We can't take a stand for Jesus. Daniel chapter 3. And this were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They were in Babylon. And the king Nebuchadnezzar said an image and said that at the worship of the sow tree and the lion and the harp, everybody shall bow down to the image. But these guys told us, the king, we are not careful to bow. And the king said, who is that God that can save? They said, king, even if you put us in a burning furnace, we will not compromise. Listen, one day the pastor was preaching and some armed robbers entered the church. And they said that those who are saying they are Christians should stand on the left. And those who say they are not Christians should stand on the right. Anybody who says I'm a Christian, I will shoot you and kill you. Everybody move to the right. They renounce Christianity then. They said, please, I would rather save my life than to claim to be a Christian. And so he said that if you are not Christian, then move out. Then everybody left the church, including the assembly training. It was left with the pastor and his wife and the two other people. And the person, the arm of us removed their masks, not knowing they were church members. He said, pastor, we want you to be a real church member, those who are real Christians in this church. These days, Christians, when you choose to say, renounce Jesus or not. Jesus, meanwhile, the people who handed over Christianity to us, they were burned, they were martyred, but they said, we'd rather choose to die for Christ. We'll never dishonor Jesus. They said that we'll stand for Christ. Now, God is calling us to stand for Him in this generation. In this generation where even becoming a Christian has become colon. In this generation where it doesn't look good when you claim you are a Christian. It doesn't look good when you claim you are a pastor. People don't even respect you again. God is calling a generation back that will stand before Him in the beauty of His integrity. They'll tell themselves that even if I die, I shall die for the Lord. He said that he that saves his life shall lose it. But he that loses his life for my sake shall gain it. God is calling the church back to the place of convictions, where we shall be convicted in our Christian life. Whether we serve God, listen, this our convenient Christianity, where you serve God when you feel like it. When you don't get what you want, you leave the church. Oh, when it rains, you never come to church again. When it is rainy season, you see most churches are empty. Meanwhile, when it is still rainy season and people ask them to go for money, they go. They still go to work because they know their money comes from there. That's where their heart is. Where is your conviction as a Christian? Where is our conviction as Christians today? A conviction of that this is my character. This is the character of Christ. And I don't care. People let people laugh at me. When the boy says, if you don't sleep with me, leave. Let's break up. Can you look at the person and say, I don't care. You can leave me. I'll still stand for God. When in your office, people are saying, let's add some zeros. And you look at them and tell them, listen, I'll not compromise on my Christianity. I can't do this. My Christian values are more than this. I can't do this. When they tell you to cheat, can you look at them and tell them, please, I can't. Can you be truthful? Can you be trustworthy? Can God trust you? Can God look at your character and boast before the enemy? Can God look at you and say, I know Abraham. He said, I know Abraham that he was under his household before me and that he let them walk with me. Can God trust you?